Hello everyone, my name is Efe Toğlu. Today I'm going to talk about our circuit design to you with my partner Recep Günay. Let's start with microphone amplification, which means receiver unit. In this part of the project, we used 12 volts for the amplification of microphone with 10 kilo ohm resistor. We are using these values for the voltage division. Then we have used 20 microfarad capacitor for to prevent our AC signals from the DC offsets. Then we used an inverting amplification circuit to amplify our circuit because our input is around 20 millivolts. By doing so, we have reached our goal. Then we reached our filter design circuit. In this part, we have three filters. As you know, we have three frequency values for separate modes. We have 698 Hz for left and 523 Hz for straight. And we have 987 Hz for the right scale. We want to show you just the straight line filter because the rest are the same. Let's start with this straight line filter. For this purpose, we have used second order bandpass filter, which is cascaded with another bandpass filter to increase the quality factor. And these resistance values and capacitor values are chosen according to transfer function, which can be found by making the phase analysis. Let's look at the transfer function. Here we can see the transfer function, and these formulas are obtained from the transfer function. We have chosen the resistance values and capacitor values according to these center frequencies and quality factor and gain as we wish. So these values are arranged according to these values. After this process, we have used a half-wave rectifier for converting AC signal to DC current, because we want to compare the three filters' outputs by the op-amps, and we are going to use this current for the driving the motors. And that's all for me. I will give my speech to Recep Günay.
Hello, my name is Recep. My friend Huzefi has explained a part of the circuit to you, and now I will explain the rest of the circuit. Let's start with the buffers part. We used three buffers in order to isolate any effect from the rest of the circuit. We used a summing amplifier in order to obtain a larger from this every one of the outputs, and then we used three different amplifiers in order to compare the output of the summing amplifier and the left and right output of the filters. Finally, we used two motor driver circuits for two motors. We used two transistors in order to increase the gain because the output current of the op-amps is very low. Let's analyze the circuits for different cases. Let's assume that turn left command is given. If turn left command is given, output of the summing amplifier will give a minus voltage, and its magnitude will be greater than the output of the left. The output of the right filter will be zero. This difference amplifier will give a greater voltage than this one. If this voltage is greater than this one, the voltage across the right motor will be greater than the left motor. Finally, right motor will move faster than the left motor, so the motor will turn, the car will turn left. Let's assume that go straight command is given. If go straight command is given, the output of left and right filters will be zero. Only there will be a voltage at this straight filter. There will be only voltage on summing amplifier output. So the different amplifiers will give the same output. There will be the same voltages at the two bases of the motor driving circuits. Therefore, there will be the same voltages across the two motors. So the car will move straight. There is no need to explain the turn right command because it is very similar to turn left command. That's all for our circuit analysis. Thank you for listening.
Finally, I would like to show you our interlinked circuit design.